Hello, God. Hello, guys. Narunash here. And today we are going to create a Python program which is gonna change Celsius to Fahrenheit and vice versa. Here, so let's hop into it. It's been a long time since I created a video, because now with this COVID-19 still going on, the country which I'm in, people are starting to go to school. Some I'm also going to school, so yeah, it's gonna, yeah, that's why I haven't been posting for quite some time. So we gotta have to create a GitHub repository. I created mine, it's gonna be in the description below. Yes, I've called it Celsius to Fahrenheit Converter. So yeah, if you've done all my steps, if you don't know what GitHub is, you can go and check out my GitHub tutorial. So if you know what GitHub is and you've been following up with my series, you know that I've been making how to learn how to make a HTML website, and I've done Bootstrap and I've done GitHub tutorials. So yeah, so if you already created that Celsius Fahrenheit Converter, you can come with me. If you haven't, just pause the video, then create a new one. So if you have, let's start. So I'm gonna have my input. I'm gonna say print, this is a converter which changes Celsius to Fahrenheit and vice versa. So because for this vice versa, oh okay, I've made a mistake. Gotta put open speech marks. I'm using VS Code. You can use any other code editor which I used to, but I'm gonna use VS Code. So here it's going to be Celsius, or I can just do that Fahrenheit. So this input is going to be asking, do you want to change Celsius to Fahrenheit or Fahrenheit to Celsius? So here it's gonna be an input. So do you want a, you can, it's usually nice to like put it a short form that you read, then you write in Celsius to Fahrenheit or vice versa, just like a Celsius. Can do something like a Celsius to Fahrenheit, or the spelling, or can do b Fahrenheit, there's no e here, Fahrenheit to Celsius. Yeah, so that's how their first input is going to be. So here we're gonna have our if statement. If Celsius to Fahrenheit is equals to A, or I can just do A, or Celsius Fahrenheit is equals to that, like that, or you can write as many as you want, it really doesn't matter. So I'm gonna have, if they're gonna write the all of it, so I'm gonna do that. There are a lot of possibility, or I just copy this, control C, and then paste it here, control V, or I'll do is equals to A Celsius to Fahrenheit. There are all of those options, really doesn't matter much. I'm going to say, I'm going to have my input, the another input. I'm going to say Celsius is equals to float. You better put this as a float, because degrees usually has like a decimal point or two. Really depends. So we're going to put that as a float. So if someone puts like 36.5, it doesn't show an error, because if you put it integer, it only allows numbers. So Celsius is equals to float input, enter your degrees in Celsius. So I went online and searched the formula for Celsius to Fahrenheit. So I found this C, the one I have highlighted, represents this input, and then that's times 1.8 in Python way. So we're just gonna be, so that is gonna be the Celsius input times 1.8 plus 32 after you do the calculation. So I'm gonna have a new variable called calculations is equals to open brackets Celsius times 1.8 times 1.8 plus 32. So I can do that, I can string all of that, you can do string all of that, and then you print the answer in Fahrenheit is, I just say comma Celsius, or there's another, you can just do the same thing as this, you can just do the same exact thing. Okay, there's gonna be some little changes, or you can do it this way. Here, then you're putting a string, you can just leave it like that, and then when you come to print, you can then you come here, you can do plus Celsius, but it's more recommended you do, you can do plus Celsius like that, or you can do comma string, so you're gonna string Celsius. Both ways do work, but I like the first way better, so let me comment that. I like this way better. So I save, so I'm just coming to open Celsius to Fahrenheit to see if the program works. Yeah, so this is how you can check, because it's also online. So that's how I search for my formula, 9/5. So if I come to my calculator, I do 9/5 is going to be 1.8. So that's why I was getting this 1.8. So I just run this program. So it's been asked, do you want Celsius to Fahrenheit or Fahrenheit to Celsius? Only have one, so I'll say here. So we, so it's going to error degrees in Celsius. I'll say 32 degrees. Okay, and if I put here 32, okay, there's a problem with our program. So let me try and remove that. If I try and remove that, I'm gonna put A, I'm gonna try 32. Okay, that's weird. And if I try like that. So I hope this will work, and I put a plus there. So I'll say A, 32. My answer, oh, okay. So I'm gonna, you gotta string that. Oh, wait, I've seen my problem. I can just do Control Z. Everything was okay then. So here, I've printed Celsius down this variable of calculations. So that's where my problem was. So if I run this again, I click A, and then I click 32, it's going to say 89.6. That's what it says here. So if you haven't done this code, pause the video and do it. If you've done it, we can go to the next part. So here, it's done. I like spacing it out. So here, we're gonna put our elif statement for the second one. Okay, I can leave that there. So it'll be mostly the same thing. So I can just come and copy this. There really won't be a big change, except from here it's gonna be elif. Right. Here I can just put elif is equals to b. You can change that to b is equals to, wait, I can do control x, control v, and then this set of trials, control x, then I do control v. Make sure you change that to b so you don't want the user to get confused. So control x, control v, then this Celsius, control X to control V. I'm putting a little programmer that I'm doing all of that. If you're the opposite of me, you can just type all of this out so I can check B Fahrenheit to Celsius, Fahrenheit to Celsius. So everything is okay. There's one more missing here. A Fahrenheit Celsius. Oh, and we have another one, which is something like this. I'm gonna add it to the first one. I'll just remove that A. So it's gonna be like the same for this one, but now without the A. So yeah, you can do it as much as this. Oh, whoopsie. Just copy that or paste. So I'd remove that A. Okay, now in part B, it's gonna be almost the same. We're just gonna have Fahrenheit is equals to float input enter your Fahrenheit. Sorry about the wrong spellings, I'm not really good at grammar, so yeah. Calculation. I really don't want to name them the same so I don't confuse. String. So we got the formula here again. You can do Celsius to Fahrenheit. Or yeah, you can do that. This is just for checking. So it's 5/9. 5 divided by 9 is 0.55555556. So that's the same thing I did here. You can put it as that long. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Cause it's a recurring decimal. Yeah, so we're just gonna do that long as what the calculator told us. So it's Fahrenheit and Google. Fahrenheit times. You might wanna copy this if you've done it in your calculator. Something like that. Copy, it's 5/9. Multiply by that. And then if you come here, wait, wrong formula. Okay, let's say Fahrenheit is 0. So it's Fahrenheit minus 32 multiplied by this big number. So yeah, and paste. So that's how it's supposed to be. My formula here is wrong. So yeah. Okay, so here now we can just print the answer in Fahrenheit in Celsius is comma calculation. Calculation. Save. Oh, I need to close that second one. Because I want to, Okay. That's good. Oh, wait. I don't need to, actually. Because I have that one, that one, that one, that one. Okay. Let me show again. Oh, dear. Yahoo. Oh, you can put in it if you want. Okay, it's shown that, so everything's okay. So the answer in Celsius, ah, grammar again. Celsius, oh wait, that's no problem. Okay, so yeah, let's run this. So we're gonna try B. So what's your answer in Fahrenheit? So we're gonna come here, let's say 56. Okay, let's put 58. Does anyone does 55.6? Okay, 32. Okay, yeah, let's just put 32. So we really don't have much time. So it's 32. It's 0.0. So we say B. Say 56. It's 56. 13.333. This one did that for times 6. That is gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4. So here you can also do, you can do times 4 if you want 4 decimals of them. So if you want, you can have 3 of them. So new run it B, and then I say 56, 13.32. It's gonna round it off. So you can have that as, you can have how many decimal places you want. Yeah, so I put 52, it's gonna be, oh wait, it's 56. Okay, so yes, now time to go to the else part. So this is what, if someone writes anything else, print, I did not understand you. And you save. So I want it to repeat after that, so I'm gonna put a function here, the Celsius to Fahrenheit vice versa. That's a long function name. I think I know better. See, C to F cell to far. Yes, so yeah, wanna put all of that in it, indent, and then I call the function. So it's far. So yeah, I'm gonna call it to. Let's try and check our program. So here I want, let's say I put C, I didn't understand here. So let's say break. So it runs and breaks. It's outside the loop. That's a problem. Okay, now Control Z. So it's repeating. So I did not understand you. We're gonna fix that problem later. You can just say I did not understand you. Please run program again. So I'm gonna save that. Main important thing, push it to GitHub. If you don't know, check on my GitHub tutorial. So the link for this repository will be in GitHub in the description below. So I'm gonna hit push. So guys, okay, that's a problem. Hit push origin master. Okay, it's failing. So I'm gonna try it on my File Explorer. Just gonna go there really quick. So here I'm gonna create opening terminal. Twitter for Twitter. I have made some changes. Then git push. So it's gonna be asking me your username. It's been long, so it's a capital N and a capital N. Nash. Password. Password is secret, doesn't show. Okay, so that's done. I'm gonna